it is a stylized look in the strain. In my mind, like a graphic novel, but we want to make it real, giving it a genuine look. Very dark, moody, many details, but it's super creepy. This is our New York subway train set that we're just building right now. What we ended up doing is it was very expensive and time-consuming to go to the actual closed subway set, and so we decided to shoot everything on this set for our end sequence.
Come on, the station's closed.
There's been a lot of encounters between Nora and Kelly throughout the season, and then we'll just get the last one where Nora is gonna die.
I'm ready! What are you waiting for?
I think it's just kind of great that the fate of Nora is gonna go in Kelly's hands.
Stop! No!
I'm really not sure what the Master has in store. Whether Kelly is a pawn or not is not really a concern of hers. She's just hellbound to find Zach.
It's sad for her life to end so quickly. It's just gonna take the show onto a very different direction from the books.
We see Nora lose to Kelly as a really tragic, powerful, and poignant moment, but was necessary to put in motion a whole series of events that'll drive season 3. At the end of the season, the spread of this vampirism is continuing to rise. Where is that going to lead?
The stakes are that much higher as they go after this almost impossible feat to take down this monster.
That's one thing that I think the show really does successfully is constantly ratcheting up the stakes and making it just worse and worse and worse.
The Master is taking things to a whole other level. Bigger things are in store.